Welcome back to All Golds TV. I'm Danielle and I'm here in Enfield, the temporary home of the London Skolars. Last season, London Skolars won all three games. A game at home I remember very well, actually, at the Prince of Wales Stadium. London Skolars' score was 38-22. However, at one point, the All Golds were down 36-6. They came back with three converted tries and a drop goal in the last minute. Stay tuned today to see how they get on and join us afterwards as we do some interviews. Thank you.
Let's go.
A huge congratulations today, Steve. Your first game with the club. The score was 34-24. Talk us through it from the beginning.
Delighted, obviously. I think I don't think the scoreline probably reflected how dominant we were in the game. To be fair, I think we've obviously outscored them with a few tries, and I'm delighted we've won. I think the effort that the players have put in. You know, there was a spell in that game where we could have lost. You know, they had a lot of pressure on our line, with a lot of injuries, and made a lot of subs quite quickly. And in this heat, it can take its toll. But we found a way to win, and I'm delighted that we've won. A little bit disappointed it took us that long to get a few scores in front, because I thought it was quite dominant throughout the game.
Yeah, I was listening to the fans' responses, and they were saying it was a bit of a ifs, buts, and maybes game as we went along.
It was. And fair play to London as well. I think they came at it. They've obviously had a bit of a roasting in the changing room from Joe, and they came and did really, really well in the second half. But we defended our goal line defence. This is a team that's conceded over 30 points a game. So considering that, and considering the heat and the injuries we had, young Danny came off, and a few of the others came off. It was an immense effort, and I thought some of the football we played as well, in the first half, and the tries we got were superb. So a lot to build on. It's one out of one from what we're saying, but we've certainly got to improve for next week against Oldham.
Brilliant. It's lovely to speak to you. How do you feel on a personal level? Your first game, a safe win?
Delighted. It's a good place to be. Obviously being a Wigan lad and hearing about the All Golds and hearing about Gloucestershire University, I think from being outside, you don't realise how good the facilities are. You don't realise how good the people are. And to be fair, you don't realise how good the players are. We have to change this mentality at the club that, we're an easy 3 points. I think a lot of people from outside the area say we're playing the All Golds and we'll get the 3 points and we'll get on the bus and go home. That's got to change. And from what I've seen today, the effort's there. Certainly the application was there, with a bit of improving and a bit of tweaking. Hopefully that can continue.
I'm joined now by Casey Canterbury, whose debut with the club. How did it feel today?
Yeah, it was amazing to get back out on field. I love every minute of it. I only wish I could have played longer and got more tries under my belt.
Yeah. Congratulations on scoring 2 tries. How did that feel?
Felt amazing. I mean, playing on your debut and getting a couple of tries, it's always good. It just lifts the morale of the team and gives a good spirit to everyone, good go forward, and thankfully we won game and played well.
And how has it been so far with the club?
No, the club's really well. They've got a good setup down here. I'm loving all the facilities. It's a good setup, yeah, I love it.
Week turnaround now then. Do you think you'll be selected to start next week then?
Yeah, hopefully get back in squad next week and another good win, hopefully. Playing at home next week, so should be a good match, yeah.
Anyway, in particular, you plan on celebrating?
Good recovery, go home, good recovery, and get back down, good training session and back to winning.
Thank you.
No worries, thank you very much. Cheers.
That's lovely to hear. You've got a week turnaround now, I believe, until Oldham at home. How do you feel about that?
Can't wait. Oldham's a club that's quite close to my heart, Oldham. You know, my dad played there, and I know a lot of people there. I know the chairman, and Scott Naylor is a coach that that I used to coach myself at Salford Reds. And again, you know, they're a team that spent a lot of money. You know, they're in a hotbed of rugby league, Oldham, one of the best towns, and some of the youngsters what come from Oldham are fantastic, and they've got high aspirations this year. You know, they need to get promoted, so big challenge. We have to improve, but you know, we'll certainly be waiting for when they come.
Well, considering today's back and forward, what is it that you're going to be doing this week that's going to make that difference for next week?
I think it's just everything. We just went away from our game plan. We had a real specific game plan, and when we did it, it worked.
Don't share that.
No, I won't share. I think anybody that sees the video will see that, but. Yeah, and it's just a habit, you know. When we did it, it worked exceptionally well, and the players really bought into it. When we went away from that, you know, we invited London back into the game, and you know, fortunately, the last 10 minutes we went back into the game plan, and I heard Craig Cook behind the sticks, you know, giving a little bit of a talking to, and to be fair, they showed a lot of character to come back. So, we've got a game plan to look at. We'll obviously look at Oldham's games, and we've got to stick to that.
Did you ever have doubts throughout the game at all? Or do you always keep a steady head?
No, I'm always quite positive, really, in the game. I always knew that if we stuck to what we'd said we wanted to do, we'd score points, you know, and that was proven that. You know, there was a big doubt when we lost, you know, three players in the space of 4 minutes, because in this heat, you know, you're limited with your subs, and, you know, London really came at us. But, no, I was really positive. You know, I've got fully belief in the players, and hopefully they've got belief in the coaching staff as well, and if we do that, then I think we'll do all right.
Brilliant. Well, thank you for joining me, and best of luck next week.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, that's it here in Enfield. I'm delighted to tell you the All Golds have won 34-24. Join us next week. We're at home at the Prince of Wales, where we take on Oldham. Thank you.